الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome you all, my brothers in Islam, to lesson 231 of Al-Arabiya to Bayn Yadayk, book 1, part 1 of the new version. وقفنا أيها الإخوة في بداية صفحة 166. We stopped at the beginning of page 166. فسأبدأ الآن إن شاء الله بشرح هذه أو هذا الحوار. I will start إن شاء الله with explaining this حوار. حوار بين ندى وإلهام. ندى اسم علم مؤنث عربي. So ندى is a feminine Arabic proper noun. وقد مر معنا هذا الاسم في المفردات المساندة. This noun, هذا الاسم, this noun, ندى, has come across us in the supportive vocabulary في موضوع الجوي, at the topic or subject of the weather. إذن الندى is dew, is dew, وهو البلل, it's the moist, the wetness, الذي يظهر على الأزهار, that appears on الأزهار, وهناك جمع ثاني, this is a second plural form, that is زهور, so it's the moist, the drops that appears on the flowers. والمفرد أيها الإخوة one flower زهرة. وأيضا يظهر الندى, the ندى أيضا appears على on النباتات, on the plants. نباتات are plants. وزهور and أزهار are flowers. وهناك جمع ثان كسابقه, this is a second plural as its previous, and that is زهور and أزهار. We have also here two plurals, and that is نبات. إذن نباتات ونبات, plants. والمفرد or مفرده, its single form is نبتة, one plant, نبتة. و يظهر الندى على غيرها, يعني الندى appears on other than it, كالنوافذ, like the windows. طيب, إذا ندى قالت السلام عليكم, فأجابت إلهام. إلهام replied by saying وعليكم السلام. ما معنى إلهام؟ إلهام ممنوع من الصرف. It's prohibited to have تنوين. So إلهام اسم علم مؤنث عربي. It's an Arabic feminine proper noun. مأخوذ من, it's been taken from the word, من الكلمة, مأخوذ من الكلمة إلهام. So إلهام with one dhamma is taken from the word إلهام with two dhamma. Okay, so we actually have to go back to its original situation, what is two dhamma. So when is إلهام with two dhamma? It's very easy if it's not a name of a person. Okay, and it's a female name. So if it's not a name of a female person, then it's to Dhamma. So ilhamun means inspiration. Ilhamun, inspiration. وهو مصروف, and it's مصروف meaning not ممنوع من الصرف. مصروف means that it accepts the تنوين. Okay, if it's without L, if I say the inspiration, it's al ilhamu, and if I drop the L, I just say inspiration is ilham ilhamun. إذن فهو مصروف, it's with dual dhamma. إذا لم يكن علما, so if it's not a proper noun, then you should give it its full to dhamma back. When it becomes a name of a woman, then at that point it's a alamun, and at that point you drop one of the two dhamma. إذن قالت إلهام وعليكم السلام. اسمي ندى, أنا سورية. My name is Nada, and don't say I am Nada because that's Anna Nada and not Ismi. So Ismi is my name is. Ismi Nada, Anna Suriyatun. I'm Syrian. Suriyatun jinsiyatun. It's a nationality. Walaysa isma baladin. It's not the name of a country. Ismu al-baladi Suriya. بالألف الممدودة with ألف stick كما درسنا في بداية الكتاب as we have studied in the beginning of the book. قالت إلهام اسمي إلهام. My name is إلهام. أنا سعودية. I'm Saudi. أنا سعودية. وكما تسمعون as you lot can hear أنا أؤكد على ضمة السين. I emphasize the dhamma on the sin. لأن البعض ينطقها بالفتحة. Because some, they pronounce the sin with a فتحة. وهذا خطأ. And this is a mistake. So it's سعودية. Okay. نسبة. نسبة. نسبة إلى. This is a very important word. هذه عبارة مهمة. This is an important phrase. ماذا أعني بالعبارة? What do I mean with العبارة? This too. نسبة and إلى. نسبة إلى. And as you can see, نسبة has two فتحة. نسبة has two فتحة because it's a مفعول لأجله. مفعول لأجله. So we have مفعول به, object. مفعول فيه, what is a time related adverb slash place related adverb, and then we have also مفعول لأجله. All these nouns get a fatha, so it's not only the object مفعول به, but there are multiple nouns that get a fatha. Yes, they're not many, but there are few. So مفعول لأجله, and you can also call it like some scholars. Some call it مفعول له, and there's two things with one meaning. So you can either say مفعول لأجله or مفعول له. And this is something you will study later on, inshallah. It will not come in the next book and not in the book after it. It will be in the fourth book, inshallah, as far as I know, or even later. والله أعلم. So مفعول له. And that's why it's nisbatan. So when you use this phrase, you always give it two fatha on the tamar buta. What means nisbatan? Nisbatan ila. It goes with ila. Nisbatan ila al mamlakatu al arabiyatu al saudiyatu. It's related to. Nisbatan ila. There's a better word than the word related to. لحظة من فضلك. نسبة إلى. نسبة إلى. It's ascribed. It's traced back to. نعم. It's traced back to. نسبة إلى. مثلا تركي is نسبة إلى تركيا. Okay, it's ascribed to Turkey. It refers back to Turkey. Okay. So anything is just not just nationality. The word Jubeilun, a small mountain, is nisbatan ila jabal. Nisbatan ila jabalin. It's ascribed to, it's attributed to the jabal. It goes back, it refers back to, it's traced back to jabal. Okay? So, Saudiyatun, what is, hiya Saudiyatun, she's Saudi, it refers back to this name. المملكة العربية السعودية. ما معنى المملكة؟ المملكة is the kingdom. As you can see, we have the word ملكون in it. ملكون. لحظة من فضلك. نعم. Then we have issue are maybe familiar with. We have multiple countries that start with al-mamlakatu, okay, or mamlakatu if it's mudaf without l. So a mamlakatun is a kingdom, and as you can see, these three letters, the mim, the lam, and the kaf, malikun is a king. Malikun wal jam'u mulukun bil waw, kings. إذن المملكة is the kingdom. العربية is the Arabic. So the Arabic kingdom of Saudi Arabia. السعودية. Okay. And السعودية has a dhamma. لماذا? Why is السعودية with a dhamma? Why are you so strict with that? Because of this. وهي أيضا نسبة. It's also an ascription إلى محمد بن سعود. So Muhammad, the son of Saud, it's an ascription. I know that Nisbatun here has a Dhamma and there it has a Fatha because it has a reason. Okay. When does it have a Fatha, Nisbatan ila? If you can ask yourself the why question. Why is it named like that, Nisbatan ila? I don't want to make you confused, just forget it for now. So, As-Saudiyatu is an ascription to, is a nisbatun ila Muhammad ibn Saudin. That was the name of the founder of Saudi Arabia. His name is Muhammad ibn Saudin, and that's why we don't put a fatha on the scene, but we put a dhamma. Okay? Mu'assisu al-baladi, he's the founder. He's the establisher. Mu'assisun is a founder or establisher. He's the founder of the country known today as Saudi Arabia. So that's why I say As-Saudiyatu. What is an ascription to him? بعد ذلك, after that, أنا طالبة. I'm a female student. أنا طالبة في جامعة دمشق. أنا طالبة في جامعة دمشق. I'm a female student in the University of Damascus. You know, it's really painful to hear some of the brothers who don't know what Damascus is. I mean, for those who know it, it sounds strange, but really there are people, they don't know what Dimashq is. Dimashq. Okay? And even if you say it in English, Damascus, they don't even know where this place is. And subhanAllah, this shows some huge ignorance in about the history of the Islam with these youngsters. I have spoke with multiple brothers, and when we came to Dimashq, they didn't even know what it is. And this is something very alarming, because Dimashq used to be the headquarter of the Khilafah, the Umayyad Khilafah. That's where the headquarter was. Okay, and in that time there used to be Sahaba radiallahu anhum in the Umayyad Empire. So it's very strange for people to say, I don't know what it is. But if you ask them, where is Roma, where the Vatican is, where the Christian, the Catholic people are, they say, yeah, Roma's in Italia. Okay, where is Dimashq? Maqarrul Khilafati, the headquarter of the Islamic Empire for so many years, after it was after being in Medina for a long time. They don't know Dimashq. So it just shows the situation of many of our youngsters in this ummah, subhanallah. Then, أنا طالبة في جامعة دمشق. I'm a female student in the University of Damascus. في حرف جر preposition. جامعتي, as you can see, كما ترون, مكسورة لأنها اسم مجرور, because it's اسم مجرور, that's why it has a كسرة. وفي نفس الوقت, at the same time, جامعتي مضاف, it's مضاف. دمشق اسم مضاف إليه. Okay, because you have the off meaning between the two words, between University of Damascus. So هذا ليس أصلا, this is not the root form. الأصل والأصل دمشق, it's with one ضمة. And as you know, the مضاف إليه that has normally one ضمة cannot have a كسرة but one فتحة instead. دمشق, this is the original word, دمشق. تقول مثلا, دمشق كبيرة, Damascus is big. وهي عاصمة سوريا, and it's the capital of Syria nowadays. Okay, it was not only the headquarter of the Umayyad Empire, الخلافة الأموية, ولكنها أيضا اليوم, it's nowadays عاصمة سوريا, is the capital of Syria. وكانت في الماضي, it used to be in the past, عاصمة الخلافة الأموية. It used to be the capital of the Umayyad Empire. وهي ثاني أكبر مدن سوريا بعد حلب. And it's the second biggest city of this, it's the second biggest of the cities of Syria after Halab, Aleppo. Or what is left of Aleppo, Allah musta'an. So after Halab, Aleppo, this is the second biggest city, what is Damascus. وتعد دمشق إحدى أقدم مدن العالم. Damascus is being counted or has been seen as one of the oldest cities of the world. If you look back, subhanallah, you will be amazed how old Damascus is. It's one of the oldest cities in the whole world. نعم, تعد, it's considered as, it's counted as, or regarded as one of the oldest cities, oldest of the cities of the world. دمشق ممنوعة من الصرف. دمشق كما درسنا قبل قليل, as we have studied a bit before, is ممنوعة من الصرف. It has only one ضمة. لماذا؟ لسببين, because of two reasons. للعلمية, because of being a proper noun. والتأنيث, and also because of being feminine. And that's why I say Dimashq كبيرة and not كبير. Okay, so If you have a proper noun and it's feminine, whether it's name of a woman, Khadija, Hafsa, Aisha, or a name of a city, then it's feminine straight away. وَالْمُدُنُ كُلُّهَا مُؤَنَّثَةٌ And all cities are feminine. So they're proper noun, they're feminine. فَائِدَةٌ A benefit, inshallah. مَعْنَى كَلِمَةِ دِمَشْقُ The meaning of the word. دِمَشْقُ مَا مَعْنَى دِمَشْقُ اخْتُلِفَ فِي مَعْنَاهَا There's a difference in opinion about its meaning. So there is a difference of opinion about the meaning of دمشق. فقيل, so it has been said that دمشق هي كلمة عربية, it's an Arabic word. تعني, that means الإسراع, acceleration, rushing, hurrying. وسميت هكذا, it has been called like this, هكذا, لأن الذين بنوا المدينة, بنوا المدينة, لأن الذين بنوا المدينة, because those who have built the city, دمشق, now we have gone into a verb, هم دمشق, they hurried, أي أسرعوا, it means the same, أسرعوا, they hurried, They hastened في بنائها in its building. Okay. So if building a city takes normally this amount of time, they've done it in a much quicker way. والله أعلم. قالت إلهام. إلهام said, أنا طالبة في جامعة أم القرى. I'm a female student in the University of Umm al-Qura. Umm al-Qura means the mother of the villages. The mother of the villages. Qura are villages. وَالْمُفْرَدُ قَرْيَةٌ كيف ننطق هذا الاسم؟ How do we pronounce this noun, قرى؟ تنطق بفتحتين. تنطق, it's been pronounced بالفتحتين with the two فتحة. حالة الوصل. In a situation of continuing. okay. وبالألف. So قرى. You say قرى if it's in the middle of the sentence, because you're continuing, there's a word coming after it, you say Quran, okay? وَبِالْأَلِفِ, it's pronounced with the alif, حَالَةَ الْوَقْفِ, in a situation of stopping, meaning if it's in the end of the sentence, like here, you don't say فِي جَامِعَةِ أُمِّ الْقُرَنِ, فِي جَامِعَةِ أُمِّ الْقُرَى, but anyway, there's also another issue, and that is, If you have L, you will never have two fatha being pronounced. But if I say, for example, في جامعة أمي قرى without L, then I pronounce it with قرى with the alif because it's in the end of the sentence. And if there is L, you never say two fatha at the end, yeah, because L never goes with two fatha. Okay. So I say, for example, هذه قرى جميلة. These are beautiful villages. هذه قرى جميلة. But if I make it definite, إذا قمت بالتعريف, if I make it definite, I will say هذه القرى جميلة. Because of L, although it's middle of the sentence, L will prevent you from making a nunation sound. It prevents from two fatha. إذن تنطق بالفتحتين حالة الوصل وبالألف حالة الوقف أو في حالة اقترانها or when it's coupled بأل التعريف. تقول مثلا you say for example القرى هادئة. The villages are quiet, are calm. And there is an ayah in the Quran where the word qura نعم وجعلنا بينهم وبين القرى التي باركنا فيها قرى ظاهرة وقدرنا فيها السير. Have you seen? In one ayah you have two situations. We have the situation with al, where you pronounce it with alif, and you have qura without al, where you give it two fatha. وجعلنا بينهم وبين القرى التي باركنا فيها قرى ظاهرة وقدرنا فيها السير. نعم وأصل العبارة the root form of this phrase I mean أم القرى is with a dhamma because we have في حرف جر جامعة اسم مجرور وهو مضاف أمي مضاف إليه وهو مضاف القرى مضاف إليه. So أم القرى is the root form. لكن كلمة أمي but the word أمي with the شدة and a كسرة above the letter below the شدة is مضاف إليه. هنا here. وهي مضاف أيضا. It's at the same time it's مضاف to the next word what is القرى. لما بعدها of what follows it. وقد درسنا مفرد قرى من قبل. وقد درسنا مفرد قرى من قبل. We have studied the single form of villages before. من قبل means before. So أم القرى is the mother of the villages. And what do they mean with أم القرى? What does it refer to? That's something I will start with in the next class, inshallah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.